Now let's jump into a demo for some of these capabilities that I just spoke of. And let's start with Azure Log Monitoring integration. So where we start? We start in diagnostic settings. So this is my web application. I now navigate to diagnostic settings. And in the interest of time, I've already made a diagnostic setting, but just to give you a feel of how things look, basically what you do is you make a choice of what kind of logs you want your web app to emit to the Azure Monitor logging experience. Do you want to include metrics? How long do you want to retain these logs? And where do you want to emit these logs? So you can basically send these logs over either to a log analytics workspace, you can archive them to a storage account, or you can even stream these logs to an event hub. So you have multiple options on where you emit your logs. Once you have done this setting, basically what you get is you can now start looking at the logs. And again, it's a very, very simplified experience for you to go through and get some important information out of these logs. For example, I can simply click here and say, show me a count of app logs by severity. And when I click run, basically what I see is a bar chart where I'm seeing logs summarized by different levels, which could be error, information, verbose, or warning. Similarly, if I now get into app logs and if I want to again see a count of app logs by severity, I can do that as well. And I can either see a result in a tabular format, or I can go see a chart. I can see error and exception count. Okay. Thankfully, I don't have any data here in last 24 hours to show. Similarly, I can even go ahead and look at Azure metrics. So maybe I want to see a pie chart of different HTTP response codes. So the web application that I have is very simplistic. So I only have HTTP 200. But if you have, let's say, a 500 or a 404 being returned, basically that's what displayed here in the pie chart. You can even go analyze your usage and performance. You can look at any incoming requests. For example, if I want to analyze the app service health from a logging perspective, basically I can see a line graph. I can even see different results again in a tabular format. If I want to know which are the top five clients from where my app is being accessed, if I want to see top five machines. So again, if you see the richness of data that you can use with logs, and it can again be for monitoring, for error handling, for performance, for response code, and you can even set up alerts using these logs. Simply a super powerful mechanism for you to diagnose your web application. Now moving on to the next pillar of diagnostics, let's look at App Insights now. Again, how do you enable App Insights? Simply, you can either enable Application Insights at the time of creating your web application, or you can even do it later on. And remember, it could either be SDK-based or an agent-based. Simplest is doing an agent-based App Insights enablement. What you do is simply come here, enable. I had enabled it already at the time of creation of my web applications, and you simply click on View App Insights data. Now over here, if you see on the home page itself, the dashboard, I can see number of graphs. So I can see a graph about server requests. And again, I can keep hovering around to see data in point of time. I can see server response time. This is another key capability. I mean, you can even get a dynamic application map. So mine is a very simple application again, and it just talks to a database, SQL database behind the scene. But if your application was talking to multiple databases or data sources or APIs, basically that's how the whole application map gets built. You can even set up availability tests. So the idea here is that you can say, can you automate pinging my web application to test availability of my web applications from geographical regions across the globe. So I can do that. I can look at performance metrics. I mean, in terms of how my app has been performing in terms of the duration, which is an average, or the total number of requests that my application has been receiving. And if you want, you can again drill down into each of these details. What you are seeing here is average. If you want, you can only view the 95th percentile. You have all different options that, again, you can use Application Insights to monitor performance, availability, exception handling. I mean, you have all sorts of avenues that open up for diagnosing your web application. Look at the whole failures experience. If there are any errors which are happening frequently, you can look at those errors here. Now, moving on to the third very important pillar for diagnostics of your web application, which is the inbuilt diagnose and solve problems experience. And if you see, once I click on this link, what I see is this kind of a dashboard with categories, and on the homepage itself, it tells me, are there any risks or alerts? And if I just click in here, what I see here is, it's telling you that the auto heal is not enabled. Currently, I'm not utilizing the health check feature, or I am running my web application on a single instance. So there can be issues if behind the scene we are running some kind of an upgrade process. I can even go ahead and now delve deeper into different categories. So let's start by availability and performance. Now, there could be scenarios, and if you see how simple it is and for you to get into every aspect of your web application in terms of, if my web app is slow, okay. How many checks are successful? App service plan density, fine. There are no crashes reported. Handle count is fine. How about the memory analysis? Now I can go ahead and do a high CPU analysis if I want out of this experience. It will basically tell you, yeah, the CPU consumption is below 70% on the instance serving the app. So if there have been any crashes, or if there have been any errors, 404.4 or in general 400 errors, I can have a look at them here. So that was availability and performance. I can now get into and do a risk assessment. So basically, it will give me how is my web application doing in terms of best practices for availability. So yeah, I do have always on check enabled, but I don't have a health check feature enabled, or I'm not using local cache. I'm not using Azure Traffic Manager if I want to do a geo distribution of my web applications. You can even go look at using diagnostic tools. So you can set up a .NET profiler trace. You can take a memory dump. You can look at connection strings. If you want, you can simply go and say, yes, now collect the network trace and the duration. And the trace will be available in this path here, which you can basically download from Kudu console. So idea is that if you look at this whole inbuilt diagnose and solve problems experience, anytime you are seeing a performance or an exception or some kind quick risk assessment that you want to run against a web application, this should be your starting point, where we have some really, really rich set of data available for you to make a start.